Hey there, winos. This is Vince.wine. Okay, I have been in this, like, California bubble, but today I am celebrating my 100th video, and I'm in the mood for some old world wines. So I'm gonna give you, winos, some tips on how to buy Bordeaux on today's How to Wine. Okay, so I'm on my way to Total Wine right now, where I expect to find some pretty decent Bordeaux selections. Okay, so buying Bordeaux can seem pretty daunting, right? I mean, there's so much you have to know. You have to understand all the regions and rules and regulations to even know what kind of wine you're drinking. You have to know all the vintage charts to know when to drink it. And because it's mostly collectible wines made for high-end wine buyers, it can be pretty expensive, right? Wrong! Every single thing I just said is wrong. Every word in that sentence was wrong. All you have to know about Bordeaux is that it's a French wine growing region that specializes in Cabernet Sauvignon and Merlot blends. Now, just like any wine, there's different wine regions. Left Bank Bordeaux focuses on Cabernet Sauvignon blends, and Right Bank Bordeaux focuses on Merlot and Cabernet Franc blends. And just like any wine, some wines do better with age. But there are vintage charts online to help you know when to drink your Bordeaux, and for the most part, they're almost all gonna be drinkable right now. Ooh, and as far as collectability, only 10% of Bordeaux production is made to be collectible wine. That means the other 90% is made to be everyday table wine. And for that reason, you can find super killer Bordeaux even at the $12 to $15 price range. Okay, so now that we know how easy it is, let's go buy some Bordeaux.
Left Bank and Right Bank.
Yeah, look at some of these prices here. I mean, this is pretty good stuff. $15, $12 here, $15, $14. Again, you just don't have to break the bank for some good Bordeaux.
Okay, this is, take a look at the price over here. So this is only $16 right here, and it's really calling my name just because it's got two words that I recognize, Graves and Pomerol. And being Right Bank, of course, Pomerol means that this is a Merlot-led blend.
Pause!
Okay, you can actually even use the free Vivino app. No, I'm not sponsored. Just to look up the wine in store. Also, it's a free app. You just take a picture of the label and right away it pops up and you can see what other wine drinkers are saying about the wine. They give ratings and reviews. You can see vintage charts, what people are saying the wine tastes like, and comparable wines and comparable prices. Kind of cool. Right Bank, that's all you gotta know. So yeah, at the $16 price range, this one's definitely calling my name.
Okay, we're back and we're gonna pop this open here, but just to give you a little bit of background, let's take a look at our map. Now, you can certainly get bogged down with all of the regions here. Again, the Right Bank, you can see Pomerol, Saint-Emilion, and Left Bank, you can see Pouillac and Graves and the Medoc regions. This river here in the middle, this is the Gironde River, and that's the estuary that splits Bordeaux in half and gives you those separate banks, and each region is certainly famous with their own chateaus and their own super high-end wines as well. Now, your bottle should tell you the region that the wine is from, but if it doesn't, it likely is just a blend from sort of all over the place. And those can be pretty cool too. And you know, probably the best thing about Bordeaux is that the people of this region have been making wine for literally thousands of years. So even in something like our $16 bottle here, we're getting a wealth of traditional winemaking and experience and incredible terroir in this bottle. So without further ado, let's get a closer look at the label. Now, one of the things about Bordeaux is that their labels can be a little bit intimidating, right? All those French words there, but it's really not that complicated. Let's break it down a little bit. So the very top line is sort of just a brag, Grand Vin de Bordeaux, right? Just means, hey, it's ground wine from Bordeaux. Here you have Graves de Gojon, which is your producer, Lalande de Pomerol. So I believe that is the proprietary name there for this wine, Appellation Lalande de Pomerol Contrôlée.
So that's your appellation, your AOC, or your wine growing region here. So this is from Pomerol, mise en bouteille à la propriété. So that just says that it was bottled on the property at the chateau. And there's a nice cool little image of what the winery must look like there. Okay, I will be honest with you, I have no idea what this one means. I don't know if that's the importer. And then of course, product of France, 2017 vintage. We've got an easy 13% on the alcohol. And this little thing right here is kind of cool. This gentleman has tasted thousands of wines to review for Total Wine. And so this celebrates part of his selections. Ooh, and a nice red capsule as well. I've been super into the osso, or I've heard it called a butler before, but especially when opening old wines, this is a good thing to use so that your cork doesn't break. I like to use it for Bordeaux as well, and actually for all wines. It's kind of fun. And the osso is pretty easy. You just get your two prongs on either side of the cork and sort of wedge left to right there. And then once it gets all the way down, just a nice little twist slowly brings up the whole cork. And there you have it, La Lande de Pomerol. Okay, let's get this bad boy in the glass here. And one thing I gotta tell you is that this is super aromatic. I can actually already smell this. Okay, so taking a look in the glass, we do have sort of a medium concentration here. I can sort of see my hand right through it, and I really love this more sort of garnety color here. Really pretty. No signs of aging just yet. This is a 2017, maybe the slightest rim variation, but otherwise a nice garnet color there. Okay, on the nose. And there it is, that just gorgeous old world terroir. That is what I have been missing. Okay, this is about medium plus in intensity. And the first thing that I'm getting here, surprisingly, is fruit. I'm actually getting some strong pomegranate there. But immediately underneath that, I am getting just the slightest kiss of Brett, or Brettanomyces, this fungus that grows with the wine. And it gives you a little bit of that sweaty saddle, kind of leather, maybe a little barnyard in there. Doesn't that all sound delicious? But then there's like this almost sweet fruit in there as well, like a sweet red fruit and dried red fruits. I've said this before, it's kind of like a dry sweetness, the way that a tea leaf can be smell sweet but be dried, or dried fruits can be still sweet but dry. Yeah, there's definitely a savoriness on here as well, a little bit of cured meat. And not too much more as far as overly complex, but man, I really am enjoying that nose. It right away just makes me think of steaks. Let's drink it. Oh, this is so satisfying. Oh, holy moly, this is good. So upon entry, it is fairly medium on the body. It's actually not this big booming body, and it also doesn't fizz out at all. It's not overly light. I'm getting some pretty medium weight here, medium on the tannin, maybe medium plus on the acidity, perfectly dry yet mouthwatering at the same time. And oh, a long finish, but it's the flavor here. All those sort of dry fruits and that sort of savory, meaty, and again, that sort of barnyard rusticness. It's all here on the palate. This wine is hitting me in all the right places, and it's so delicious. And this was $17. I will totally buy this again. Killer wine. There is also a little bit of bell pepper in here as well, sort of dried bell pepper, probably coming in from some Cab Franc and Merlot. This is killer, and the whole point of this video is just to say that there is a broad, wonderful world of wine out there, and you don't have to break the bank to enjoy it. $17 Bordeaux, and we saw a number of others in this price range that came highly rated as well. It's just so easy to find fantastic Bordeaux, so don't be afraid of Bordeaux. Go out there, get some. You're not going to break the bank, and you're going to be pretty happy. So happy exploring to you. If you enjoyed what you saw here today, please leave me a like. That helps so much. Don't forget to share this video with your wine friends. And until next time, winos, drink safe and drink well. Cheers.